Hey everybody, coming to you from Gateway Classic Cars over here outside of St. Louis, Missouri.
And today I thought you might like a look at this 1974 Dodge D200 pickup. And the reason I wanted to take a look at this one is because it's an all-original Survivor, and these are definitely getting hard to find these days. I mean, this thing is original down to the paint, the interior, everything. So I thought we'd take a closer look at it here. You'll notice right away, it's got a big chrome bumper up front. And of course, all original grill and everything. You can see it has some fog lamps back behind the grill there. Very nice. We have the Dodge block lettering across the front edge of the hood. Pretty cool looking hood ornament as well. You can see it's almost kind of like a crystal. Very nice. And like I said, this is all original paint on this truck. In fact, the owner says that this truck has only seen rain about 6 times over all those years. So definitely very well cared for. And you can see it's got the lower two-tone there. Kind of an off-white or cream color on the bottom. It is riding on the original painted steel wheels with hubcaps. Nice heavy-duty set of tires on there as well. You can see your 200 badges there on the fenders. The glass looks like new. It's got a nice set of truck mirrors on here. And like I said, the interior is all original as well. Here, we'll pop it open and take a look. You can see the door panels look like new. The seat has actually been covered in that plastic covering since the very beginning. So underneath that, you essentially have a brand new seat. Very impressive. Has the original wheel with the Dodge Ram right there in the center. And nice set of gauges on here as well. 100 mile per hour speedometer. Then you have all your auxiliary gauges to the left of that. And if I can zoom in there, you can see the original mileage is actually 99,748 miles. But like I said, it's getting pretty difficult to find a truck in this sort of condition. You can see the dashboard. It's nice and smooth, no cracking or anything. And this thing has one of the largest glove box doors I've ever seen on a vehicle. Let me pop this open so you can see. You can see that basically that whole half of the dash opens up there. Pretty interesting. I mean, it's just in beautiful shape inside and out. Very impressive. Got your fuel filler here. This is an adventurer model, so it has all the adventurer trim and badging on it. I left the headlights on. I'll have to remember that when I get around there. Nice big step bumper out back here. A little Dodge decaling here as well. I mean, just a nice straight truck all the way around. And this is the original bed paint as well. It has not been repainted. As you can see, it's been used a bit over the years, but no dents or dings. You know, it's not all banged and scratched up. It's actually in pretty remarkable shape, given its age. I mean, just a really nicely preserved truck. It does have the rear sliding window, as you can see. And this one's actually powered by a 318. Of course, the original numbers matching 318. Let me go ahead and pop open the hood and we'll take a look at it here. All right, as you can see, it's looking really impressive under the hood here as well. All factory equipment under here. Still has the factory style air cleaner up top. They have repainted the intake and valve covers and things over the years, but it's definitely looking nice in here. Still has the factory exhaust manifolds as well. I mean, just a really remarkably preserved vehicle. Very nice. I mean, it even has all its original stickers and decals. There's one up there for the tool storage so you know where your jack and things are. It's my favorite type of vehicle to find, these original survivors. It's just a rarity. It's pretty easy to find restored vehicles, but to find an original survivor that was cared for like this is definitely rare. Here, we'll go ahead and check out the specs on it. Once again, it's a 1974 Dodge D200, 99,000 miles. That 318 is backed by the Torqueflite automatic. It says 272, but it should be 727 Torqueflite. They have a lot of information on it here. You guys can pause and read all the details. It does have a set of 410 gears in the back. So it definitely could pull a trailer if you wanted to, that sort of thing.
Well, anyway, guys, hopefully you found that one interesting. I appreciate you watching and commenting and everything, and I'll see you later. Bye.